Once my guru was trying to teach me the Surya Siddhanta, means how the Panchanga can be predicted and penned down. He was trying to show how the sun is center and earth moves around the sun and moon is around the earth and the whole structure including the sun, moon, the whole thing is also moving. He described in an elaborate way. And then he took a chalk piece, just drew some numbers on various parts of my body. The numbers belong to each graha, is directly connected to our internal organs. Each graha influences one of our internal organ heavily. And he drew that numbers on my body, and he drew that same numbers on external, on the floor, explaining how when those grahas change, when those stars move, regular cosmic happenings like Amavasya, Purnima, how those things should be predicted or calculated. That is more like a calculation, it's not even prediction. But its influence on the humanity need to be predicted. Its influence on the individual's lives need to be predicted. My gurus were trying to map this whole science and explain this to me. I think almost the core fundamental structure of Jyotisha and Surya Siddhanta I am trying to explain. Chandaha padau tu vedasya astau kalpoda patyate jyotishamayanam chakshur niruktam shrotramuchyate sikshakranam tu vedasya mukam vyakaranam smritam. This is a very traditional verse. In any gurukul they will chant this and make you repeat. It's a description. Six angas of the Vedas in Veda Purusha's body. Jyotisham ayanam chakshu, meaning Jyotish Shastra is considered as eyes of the Veda Purusha. From this we understand that the Vedic astrology is as old as Vedas, or in other words, does not have beginning, anadi. This Shastra is also called Hora Shastra. Hora is an abbreviation of Ahoratram, meaning day and night. It means it is the systematic study of time and its components and parameters and its influence on physical, chemical, biological existence of what we know as life. Listen. One very funny incident happened when he was teaching me. I was so intensely immersed in his teachings. He was showing me, hey, this is Surya. This influences your brain thinking system. This is Rahu. He influences your liver. The actions liver performs physically, its influence on your thinking system everything. If you map it to the description of Rahu, it will absolutely match. Guru, Brihaspati, is the decision-making mechanism which influences your will persistence, Ajna Chakra, pituitary glands, and its impact on your existence is directly Guru. He was explaining step by step how each of these grahas and their numbers and how they influence your lifestyle patterns, everything. I'll repeat exact one line. He was touching that Rahu description of how he was describing Rahu and touched my body, infused that Rahu energy in my liver. I could see immediately so much happening inside me. I just vomited. Literally, physically, felt so fresh, alive, relieved. Of course, after cleaning all that place, everything, my guru has explained. Eera nerpatta aayul neelundambi. In Tamil, he said, if the liver is straightened out, life will increase. It is directly Rahu. Rahu is responsible for your longevity. Rahu can influence and put you in addictions and kill you, or he can keep you addiction free, or addicted to right habits and food and keep you happy, healthy for any long. This whole thing is related to your liver. If the liver decides to addict you for certain food, nothing can be done. Just by remembering that food, you will be forced, your whole system will be pushed to eat it. After eating, you will repent, but you will not stop eating. He said, integrity of the liver to the purpose of your existence makes you long, happy, healthily living. Because liver sends the signals about hunger and what kind of food you like, the taste, everything. The memories of the food and its taste flashing in your system and you being influenced to eat that same kind of food, timing, rhythm, everything is liver. whether it is alcohol addiction, which is the worst. The best addiction is addicted to fasting. Let me explain my guru Raghupati Yogi's words. Eera nerpada means if the liver is integrated, it creates right desires which keeps you healthy, which continuously detoxes you, which creates taste for healthy things. I tell you, my addiction to fasting has brought not just health, 24/7 active, alive, intense living with multi-dimensional work.